Hi, morning. It's a beautiful morning, and I thought I'll talk to you about how to live an enlightened life, how to live a life in bliss and peace. Now, our breath, mind, and body are all connected, and most of the time we are living in our mind, which is wandering. It goes from here to there, takes you everywhere. If you let the mind direct you, you will never be in peace because it will draw you into something which is completely unconcerned, and you'll be all wound up and live with that notion of life. Now in meditation, one of the things that they do or one of the ways of meditation is to concentrate on your breath. Now, in yoga, there are two principles. One is prana shakti, which is the power of your breath. And the other is chitta shakti, consciousness. And these two are forces that live eternally. Prana shakti is your breath, the energy of your breath, which is a life force. And chitta shakti is eternally present, which is consciousness. A union of these two is samadhi. So really, the rhythm of your breath is closer to your real self than your mind. In fact, your mind is completely hallucinating. Now, to really have an enlightened life is to be in tune with nature. Forget about yourself. Be in rhythm with the breath. When your mind is wandering, remind yourself, oh, that is the mind. Come back and concentrate on the rhythm of your breath. Come back to an even, calm breathing. That influences your mind and your entire body and will keep you calm. Now, in Taoism, the entire principle is about a union of nature, effortless action, and spontaneity. So, if you remember these principles of just following nature and realize you are a part of nature, and forget about yourself, which is created in the mind, an individual, which is a narrative from our birth, as the mind works on stories, and that is a story of a created person, but that may be an illusion and a ghost. What eternally exists according to Vedanta is Satchitananda, being, consciousness and bliss. And being is your breath. So if you're on the rhythm of your breath, you're in tune with the eternal stream of consciousness and start getting purer thoughts in your mind, and you're in bliss because you're in one with the union of nature, effortless action and spontaneity. You don't try and do anything. Let life direct you rather than you directing. This may not be what they teach you in the schools of management, but this is exactly what the gurus and sages have been talking about for centuries, of how to live a peaceful, enlightened life. The choice is now yours. Whether you want to chase the world, which by Hindu philosophy is an illusion and comes into being in our mind, or you want to be in peace with this journey with life. It's a short journey with this body and mind. It is eternal. That is the spirit, the witness, the awareness that you are. And to be in tune with that, you should be in rhythm with the breath. If you're in rhythm with your breath and calm, just keep your breath calm. Whenever your mind wanders, pull it back to your breath and concentrate on your breath. The mind is just wandering. With the mind, you're going nowhere. You will never find any enlightenment with the mind. Knowledge by itself is great. It educates us. Even this is a bit of knowledge. But the right knowledge, the first Shiva Sutra is knowledge is bondage. To think that knowledge will get you peace and enlightenment is a completely red herring. Knowledge will just feed your ego of your individual self, which Buddhism says is anatta, it doesn't exist. Eternally it is being, consciousness and bliss. So if you want to be in bliss and live a peaceful life, concentrate on your breath. Forget about the mind. Whenever the mind wanders and draws you here and there, come back to the rhythm of your breath and you will be in complete peace and ananda, and you will be one with nature. which is the rhythm of nature and which you really are beyond the mind. So as the Taoists say, be in effortless action, union with nature and spontaneity. Cheers.